Good morning, this class is for class 12th and as you know we are doing determinants for class 12th and in the last class I told you how to solve determinants, okay? So I'll just give you one more example so that you can understand determinants, cofactors and minors, okay? So let us look at this example here. Suppose we have a delta determinant 1, 2, 1, 0, 5, 2, 1, 2, minus 1, okay? Now we need to find the determinants. Of course, one way is expand along any row, first row. Normally students expand it along the first row. Now in this case I will also tell you what. Suppose I make a matrix out of it. This is a determinant. I make a matrix 1 2 1, okay, 0 5 2 1 2 minus 1, okay? And if this is a matrix, then we will construct two more matrix. One is minor A, another is cofactor A. So minor A, this one, okay? Minor A is when you hide all the elements here and see how you construct. One, you hide the row and column, you get minus 5, minus 4, minus 9. Two, you hide the column, 0, minus 2. One, you hide the column and rows, 0, minus 5. 0, you hide the columns, minus 2, minus 2. 5, you hide the columns, minus 1, minus 1. 2, you hide the columns in rows, this way, you get 2, minus 2, that is 0. And for this one, 2, 4, 2 to the 4, minus 5. For this one, 2, minus 0. For this one, 5, minus 0, that is 5. Something like this. Once you calculate minors, you find cofactors. Cofactor A, as you know, you can get by just changing the sign of 1, 2, 3, 4, because their I plus J is odd. So minus 9, sign came 2, minus 5, sign came 4, minus 2, 0, minus 1, minus 2 and 5. After this, we want to find the value of determinant. Now we will verify this from any row, any column. First row is 1, minus 9, plus 2, 1 multiplied by minus 5, okay, something like this. So you get minus 9 plus 4 minus 5, okay. So what you will get? You get minus 9 plus 4 is minus 5, minus 10, okay. Suppose the value of delta is minus 10. Now we have to check from second row also, third row also. Columns also you can check. So what I am doing is I am multiplying every element by its corresponding cofactor. Second row is 0 multiplied by 4, 5 multiplied by minus 2 and 2 multiplied by 0. So you see that it is also minus 10, 5 to the 10 and these are zeros. Third row we are getting 1 multiplied by minus 1, 2 multiplied by minus 2 and minus 1 multiplied by 5. So minus 5, okay, and this minus 1 multiplied by 5, so minus 4, minus 5, so again minus 10. So we have verified from all the three rows. Now you will have to verify by the three columns that you can take as homework. So what we have done is we have made a matrix from the determinant, then we have found the minor A, one matrix, then cofactor A, then we multiply every element by its cofactor, then we get the value of the determinant as minus 10. So this is just one example where you can understand minors and cofactors properly. Now in the next one, we are dealing with some of the very basic properties of determinants. Now see, in matrix we have learned 1A transpose, that is you make the rows column and columns rows. Here if there is a matrix A and we are finding its determinant, then the determinant of matrix A transpose is same as A. So that is, if you change, this is first law, if you change rows to column and columns to rows, that is if you interchange rows and columns, Okay, you get the same value of the determinant, right? That is the first law. Second law, if any two rows or any two columns are equal, then the value of determinant is 0. Two rows are equal, are same, then delta is equal to 0. Let's verify this one. Okay, let's see. We got a determinant here, 1 2 1 1 2 1, anything, 5 7 2. Now this must be 0, so expand it along 1. It's 2 to the 4 minus 7. 4 minus 7 is minus 3. This sign is changed, minus 1. 4 minus 7 is 4 minus 7 is minus 3 again, plus 5. And this is 2, right? 2 minus 2 is 0. So look at this, minus 3 plus 3 is 0. 0. So this is giving us an example that if two rows are same, or if even if two columns, these two columns are same, you can have two rows also same, then also determinant will be 0, the value of determinant will be 0. Okay, and similarly, if you have if two rows are proportional, then also the value of determinant is 0. How? But before that, I'll tell you another property, that unlike matrix, suppose we have 2, 4, 6, 1, 2, 3 and 2, 7, 8. If you can take from any row, anything common, then the value of determinant is multiplied by that common factor. You need not multiply by every element, just one row is enough. In matrix, see what I am saying. If I take 2 common here, what I will get? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 7, 8. Now you see, as soon as I take 1, 2 common, these two rows are same, so their value of determinant is 2 into 0, 0. One more thing, even if these two rows were not same, then also the value of determinant will be multiplied by 2. How? Suppose this is 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. Now if I take 2 common here, this is 1, 2, 3, and let's make this 2, 3, 5. 2, 3, 0, and 2, 3, 5. Now this is multiplied by 2 times the value of this determinant. So we can take any number common from any row or column. Whereas in matrix, if you cannot take anything common from one row, it has to be common in every element. For example, 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 2, 6, 8, 10, 15. 8, 10, 12. This is a matrix. Suppose it is a matrix, then if you take 2 common, then it is common from every element, like 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, this one. But in determinant, even if you take from one row or one column, then it just comes out. So if this is a determinant, you can take 3 times 2 common. This is suppose this is a determinant here. Suppose I write determinant A is equal to 2, 4, 6. Suppose this is 4, 8, 10. 10, 12, 14. Now what you can do is, one time you can take 2 common from here. Then you can take 2 common from here. Then you can take 2 common from here. 3 times. So you can get 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 5. 5, 6, 7, something like this. And this becomes 8 times. So this is the difference between, basic difference between a matrix and a determinant, okay? Now, we have learned that if two rows are same, the value of determinant is 0. Even if two rows are proportional, then also the value of determinant is 0 because of this property. Suppose I have just written, suppose 1, 2, 4, 6, and 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 0. Now, if I take 2 common from this one, I will get 2 common, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 0, okay? Now these two rows are same, therefore the value of determinant is 0, okay? This is a simple property. So there are many more properties, but right now we should revise this work properly. And then in the next lecture, I will give you more properties, okay? Thank you for watching.